Okay, so in this video, I'm going to show you how to write git commands in the terminal more efficiently with ZSH. Now, you're probably wondering, what is ZSH? And to understand what that is, you kind of have to go back to the beginning of Linux/Unix and think about the terminal. So the first terminal that was ever in Unix was something called the Bourne shell. And then we have the born again shell, which is bash for short. If you open up your Mac or Linux terminal, that'll be running bash by default. ZSH stands for Z shell, and this is an extension of the born again shell, so the original shell. And this allows for more customization of themes and plugins and those sorts of things. And straight out of the box, if you haven't installed any themes or plugins, you have access to all these git commands, and there's a lot of them. I'm not going to go through all of them, but I'll just go through the ones that I use. And these are shortcuts for stuff you do already on a regular basis if you already use Git in the terminal. So I use a theme called Spaceship Prompt. This is the repo. I'm going to put a link in the description if you want to follow along or if you're curious about what I'm using, but this is what I use. Okay, so in VS Code, I have a very simple, basic Rust project going. Nothing fancy here, but as you can see, I haven't committed anything. So I can press GST for git status to see the things I need to commit, and I can press G add all, and I tend to chain my commands. So I do git add all and then git commit. Now, once I hit enter on this, it's going to do git commit verbose, and that allows you to write the full commit message. So if you have a header, body, footer message, you can go ahead and do that with verbose. And that is a default alias from OhMyZSH. So let's hit enter now and see what happens. So I've got it configured to let me write my commit messages inside VS Code. I have a video to show you how to do that if you want. I'll put that in the description. But as you can see, it's opened up the window or a tab in VS Code for me to write my commit message. So I'm going to be really boring and write first commit as a message, press Command S to save and Command W to close the window, and then it will continue with the git process. And now it's done, I can go ahead and press GP to push, but I haven't connected this to GitHub or a remote, so I'm not going to do that. Now, if I want to create a new branch, it's very simple. It's just GCB, so git commit branch, and I can call it something like second branch, hit enter, and it's moved me over to the next branch. Now, if I wanted to push this branch, I could do GP, but again, I haven't connected it to remote, so I won't do that. And if I wanted to pull, it's GL, but that shouldn't work because there's no remote. But if I wanted to push this for the first time, instead of pressing just GP, it's gonna say I need to set it upstream. And the shortcut for that is GP SUP. And once I hit that, it will set it upstream for me automatically. So you can already see how much quicker it is to write these shortcuts with ZSH instead of writing the full git command. And I can do this as well. So say I change this to hello world 2, hit save, but don't commit. I can do git stash all, which will stash it and put it back to the way it was before. And if I wanted to get the stash back, so pop my stash, I could do git stash pop and it will bring it back. Now let's put the stash back to the way it was. And what I can do is do git stash list to see my list of stashes, and I only have one. So if I wanted to, I can call that back individually with the command git stash pop, and I can do stash at 0 and it will put that back for me. Now, of course, if I wanted to, I could have loads of different stashes. So I could have another stash for 3, save, and then git stash. And if I do git stash list, you can see the full list of stash commands. And of course, I can just bring back one, the one that I want. So I can select this one and just bring that back. Now, if I wanted to get rid of all the stashes I had, I can just do git stash clear and it will get rid of that and the dollar sign is gone. Now, I've only just scratched the surface of how many aliases there are in OhMyZSH for Git. So I recommend you go through this whole list and see which commands you use and just kind of learn or memorize these aliases, because the more you use them, the more effective and the quicker you'll be as a developer. Anyway, I'll have all these links in the description in case you forget, and I hope you found this video useful. Please like and subscribe for more videos like this.